All right, welcome everyone. Today what we're going to be doing is part one of a solar powered air conditioner install in my garage. I've picked up this Airspool air conditioner here, and this one's kind of unique in that it runs completely off solar panels, but you can plug it in to your main power in order to make up any kind of difference there between the solar output and what your compressor actually needs at any given time. So if it's cloudy or nighttime, you can still run air conditioning. And we do a lot of working out in the garage here, so I'm going to be using these solar panels on a ground mount system here in Florida. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you this IntegraRack IR-15 system, which is an aluminum system, supposedly rated very well for high winds, which we get a lot of here in Florida. We're gonna be using the IntegraRack spike mount system to actually mount everything together. And these crazy looking spikes here, these barbed spikes that are hollow, they get filled with an epoxy after they're kind of set in place in the ground. And that's supposed to provide a lot of ballast and uplift, because otherwise on a ground mount system, since you're not anchoring to the roof, which is anchored to the house, which is quite heavy, you need a lot of uplift force, because these things can generate like 1,000 pounds of uplift in a heavy wind situation like in a hurricane. The other cool thing about these IR-15 rack is, I haven't gotten to it yet, but according to the instructions, this back section here, I should be able to adjust the angle from fixed 15 degrees to 0 degrees, which should, in the event of like a tropical storm coming or something like that, I should be able to go ahead and set it to a 0 degree angle to have it catch the wind a little bit less. So as you can see here, I've already kind of got started with the unboxing. This is sort of what you get in the kit. Each kit comes with one of these frames, and it honestly is a lot more expensive than I thought it was gonna be initially, once I actually started pricing everything out. But each frame, it's all aluminum, comes with a long leg and a short leg here. And they also come with these IR-15 ground lugs and these attachment screws and bolts to connect everything. Now, it comes with everything you need, pretty much, with the exception of grounding equipment, and you need to get 1-inch EMT conduit. So I just went ahead and got that at Lowe's. And the conduit threads through these holes here to keep everything connected, because as you can see on nice level ground, everything's kind of sitting fine, but when it's gonna be out in the yard, it's gonna need some stability. So the idea is that the conduit threads through these holes like that from one to the other, and when you run out of conduit on one end, you would just start into the next hole and connect the next piece of conduit. And then there's set screws to keep everything joined up here. So let me show you what actually comes in the IntegraRack IR-15 box. Now you're gonna need one of these modules plus one for every row that you're starting. So in my case, I have 4 solar panels. So I'm gonna need 5 of these. So as I said, each kit comes with the aluminum base. And as far as fit and finish, there's quite a lot of aluminum shavings inside the tubes from the machining. And the outside's pretty scuffed, but you know, it's not really, honestly, a big deal. It's industrial, right? It's gonna be outside getting rained on, but you know, that's the kind of finish that you're getting. See, it's kind of banged up a little bit, but it is aluminum, so it's kind of gonna be expected. You see, these are kind of the edges, a little bit rough, sharp, so be careful on those. So here's the back leg, it drops in there. And the IR-15, since it has an angle adjustment, you wanna leave that open to the back so that you're not trying to get in there and adjust while you have a giant solar panel on top of it. So leave that exposed to the outside side. And here we have the short leg. You can see. So inside the IntegraRack hardware kit, you get these IR-15 bonding clamps, and the solar panel frame sits in that slot there. It lets you do some adjustments before you clamp it down finally. So you're gonna get 4 of those. And these are the through bolts. They're squared off, so they fit into the square location here. Just screw on the nut on the other side. And that's basically all you need to do to install these legs. So it goes through pretty fast. It's like a giant erector set for adults, so not too difficult to figure out. So here we go. Here's the remaining bolts. These are the bolts that go through here that are self-tapping to go ahead and thread onto that conduit to keep it from moving around. So again, you need that 1-inch EMT conduit. And as far as this green nut goes, you know, green usually denotes ground, except I'm not quite sure where you're supposed to officially ground these racks to. I only noticed that in the instructions, there's a point where it says don't let the ground wire, if it's copper, touch the aluminum, because that's gonna cause some galvanic corrosion there, obviously. So you wanna avoid that, but it doesn't kind of tell you where you're supposed to connect. And here's a closer look at one of the spikes that come with the IntegraRack spike kit. As you can see, it's got these barbs and the whole thing's hollow. So the idea is that these spikes go down on the ground. It's gonna thread through here. Obviously not like this because the spikes aren't gonna fit through. So it's gonna go sit from the top. But then you fill this guy with the epoxy that's included and it leaks out here, forms kind of epoxy roots as I've heard it described, and comes out of all these openings and provides quite a bit of uplift force so that I don't have to sink this into a concrete pad. But that's also another applicable option that you can do here, as well as a ballast mount where you can just either set dirt on top of there with a special kit, or parking blocks, or like anything really heavy. But I wasn't gonna really take any chances in Florida, so I'm probably gonna double up with both spikes and some sort of ballasting as well. And if the big one comes, I think I'm gonna probably just take the panels off to be safe. But what I liked about the IR-15 was the angle adjustment to go to zero angle. So if something like not devastating comes through, maybe just a high wind storm, like a tropical storm or like a Cat 1 or something, I can just adjust the panels to a less wind catching angle at 0 degrees from the fixed 15 regular, which is a pretty good compromise for Florida. I think optimal, depending on the seasons, about like 24 to 26 degrees. So I'm not losing much at 15, and that's at a lower wind uplift angle at 15 normally. So I'm not gonna be too worried about the efficiency drop there. All right, so at this point I moved the IR-15 modules that are now assembled outside. I've got the EMT conduit that I'm about to start putting through here. I just wanted to set this on the brick as a more or less level surface to kind of get the conduit through, and I'm gonna move it into place over here in this grassy area where I'm gonna drive the spikes down through. So I'm gonna see if the solar panels actually fit in this nice layout, how I like it. When I looked at this area, it shouldn't get too much shade. Even though there's the trees, this is facing the opposite direction of the sun. So now let's thread the conduit through. So we need to use two lengths of conduit because you're supposed to leave about, I think, 2 inches sticking out from either side. So I'm gonna feed the other one from the other side, but I'm gonna start to move these into a better spacing here. All right, so that's a general idea. We have our 1-inch EMT conduit threaded through both holes of the IR-15 frames, and I'm gonna measure out the spacing. You're supposed to take an inside measurement, which is 1 inch less than your panel width. So don't measure from the posts. Measure the actual conduit lengths to get your correct spacing for your solar panels. So the width of my solar panels looks to be about 44 5/8 inches. So I need to do 43 5/8 inches as my spacing. All right, so back outside, we have 43 5/8 marked. So we gotta shove him over a little bit. All right, so that was the last self-tapping conduit screw that I laid out there. So there's the final product. The 1/2-inch nut driver with the Bosch cordless here did a good job. I had to use it on drill mode to give it enough torque, just to hold on pretty tight because it doesn't want to grab your wrist. Do not use hammer mode or impact drivers for this per the instructions. You don't want to strip anything. All right, so it's day two. We had a big rain shower in the afternoon, so I decided to wait until this morning to continue. I put a string line here so that I can kind of follow this kind of wonky line in the fence here. So I have the IntegraRack IR-15 laid out here with the frames all assembled with the conduit in the middle. And now I need to do the next step, which is to install the spike anchors. So to do that, now that we have things laid out, is I need to go ahead and mark where my holes are gonna be before I pre-drill for the spikes. So I have this dowel here and I'm gonna feed it through the opening. So I think it's about a 1/2-inch opening. So I have a 1/2-inch dowel. So kind of just, or it should just barely fit. I'm going to just pound it in. So I'll just pull out this dowel now and repeat that for the remaining holes down the line. And then what we're gonna do is move the rack out of the way and then start with drilling. So for the anchor spikes, I need to drill this monster 26 to 30 inch hole. So I have this carbide bit here. I think it's a Bulldog Bosch bit. I'll put the details in my video description along with this SDS drill that I had to buy for this task, but I have to make more holes. So it's gonna be fine. Nothing wrong with owning more tools, right? So we're gonna put on hammer and drill mode, whereas the settings for just chipping and this is just for drilling. And we're gonna move this out of the way. I've marked the holes in the previous step with the dowel punch through, and I've also marked it with some spray paint just as a double safety measure. So I'm gonna shift the frame out of the way and start drilling my holes. So I'm hoping that the Bosch gets through my kind of mixture of sand and shells and limestone that I have down here in South Florida. Okay, so that worked better than I thought it would. You know, some specs said I needed the max, SDS max for this, but the SDS plus is working pretty well. I think it would have been a different story if I was going through like 20 inches of solid concrete, but I just have a lot of limestone boulders here in the yard depending where I stick the drill bit, so it's getting through the occasional giant rock just fine. Of course the last hole, right? It's being problematic. I think there's like immediately a giant rock here. That one was tough. So now I should be able to take these IntegraRack spikes and put them in the ground. I need to tap them down. I'm just going to tap that in now. All right, so lifting the rack into place was pretty successful. Definitely took two people given how long this guy is. But once I had everything in place, it was just a matter of having my assistant on the backside kind of get the first two holes lined up. And once I had those in place, we were able to set everything. So now I've moved on to starting to use my bubble levels here to kind of get a rough level before I run a string line through. And so far it's been pretty easy to kind of just move these guys up and down before I pour the epoxy. All right, now that I got everything leveled here, I can use the epoxy resin that came with the kit. So let's see what's in the box here. Okay, that's part A and part B, which is the hardener. Bottle says 24 hour cure, but IntegraRack says 8 before putting the solar panels on. So in the kit, we also have a measuring cup included. This is the handy wrench that you'll need to do a lot of the adjustments later. This is the funnel for pouring everything into the spikes. And it comes with their own pair of black gloves, which is nice. Here's our measuring cup. And we're supposed to do our mixing in the big cup and then pour it into the small cup, pour this measured sample of the mixed epoxy into the funnel in each spike and go around. So I double-checked the instructions before I started mixing everything. This is the measuring cup. You need to fill it to not the brim, but a quarter of an inch under. So looking at the other side of the box, the average working time is about 45 to 50 minutes, and the dry time is 8 hours at 75 degrees, but it's about 95, 97, and it rained. It's just humid here in Florida. I'm tired of this. So cure in 24 hours and fully cured in 72. So it's a 1-to-1, so one bottle, one bottle. Okay, self-leveling. So I think that should both fit in there. There is an included stirring stick right here. So mix for 2 minutes. Leaking out the bottom. That's awesome. So kind of a bummer that this cup had a crack in it before I started mixing, I didn't realize. So using the included bolts and washers, we're gonna do the last threading of that, which is going to close up this gap here in the IntegraRack rack mount here, which is gonna take these teeth that are almost biting around the spike kit, and it's gonna grab on and prevent uplift. All right, so now we have the ground mount rack fully secured to the ground. The spikes are driven deep, fully. They're tightened down, filled with epoxy. I've got my grounding in place, and now it's time to mount the panels. So we're gonna go ahead and grab them, stage them, gently attach the IR-15 connectors basically where we want them, and then we're gonna set them in place onto the post mounts, and then we'll see how that goes. So earlier when I rough fit everything, I decided I want these IR-15 connectors spaced out about 15 inches on the tops and bottoms of the panels. And that'll give me the kind of centering I was looking for. So you just have to unthread this nut. So the frame of the solar panel is gonna go ahead and slide into this slot here. So you want this spike bit kind of touching the frame, which is going to grind in there and create a bond to the ground mount and all the different panels. So I'm just gonna lightly tighten this to hand tightness so that it doesn't go sliding on me. Okay, so I'm in where I need to be. Are you in? Cool, cool. I'm gonna try to do the same on my side. All right, so we were able to get all four panels installed on the ground mount system here. It worked out really well. It definitely helps to have at least two, three people, four people even better, to help with centering everything while you're adjusting. So now that things are like roughly in line, I'm gonna shift these around to exactly where I want and make sure that they're all evenly aligned. So this is what it looks like when you have five of the IntegraRack IR-15 modules lined up together with four bifacial solar panels from Trina. These are the 410 watt versions. And so the last thing we need to do is go ahead and find that included wrench again and tighten up all the connections so that everything's nice and secure. And then we can get on the underside of these Trina 410 watt solar panels, wire them in series so that they can power my Airspool garage air conditioner.